And you've got it on 2K Sports for Wednesday night action in the NBA.
I'm Kevin Harlan alongside Richard Jefferson and Greg Anthony. And with us from the sidelines tonight, David Aldridge. DA, take it away.
Thanks very much. Now, guys, at the end of this season, there is a potential opt-out of the collective bargaining agreement. And after seeing star players hold out, some wonder if that will be exercised. Commissioner Silver says, we have a common interest to ensure that contracts are honored. Those are issues we can approach collectively. Kevin?
As is always the best case. David, thank you.
Now the starting group for the visitors. MP is out there with ABC. Then it's the kid. Then there's Baddest One.
And it's Roach in at the one.
And for the Cavaliers. And today, Greg, it's about the NBA. But tomorrow it's about spending Turkey Day with family and friends.
I think everyone realizes it's not something we can take for granted. Cherish those moments with your loved ones. They're likely to be your fondest memories.
And it's Virginia to start out. They set the pick. Down low. Here's Gardner, and it's denied. Here's Roach. It's rebounded by Virginia.
Well, last time out, they got the win in large part because of the play of their bench, and they provided a lot of the scoring punch.
And you can tell how important having depth is for them. Sometimes it's the difference between a win and a loss.
Six on the shot clock. And the first shot of the night for him, missing. Here in the first, a little over a minute played so far. Now, Clark. This game he had 12. It's up a three. It's good from long range.
And they don't want to get in a habit of giving him open looks from three. First quarter still, but not who you want to leave open.
And here in the first, closing in on 2 minutes play. Pass to Grandison. MP trying to free himself up. Shot's good by Grandison.
And if you're the guy who has to guard him, it is never going to be an easy night for you.
For Virginia, they've gone 1 of 3 from the field to start this one so far. Pass to Gardner. There's the killer two-handed slam.
He may not have that traditional power forward build, but his bounce, well, that kind of levels the playing field.
Here's Roach. He's covered by Clark. The pass to Whitehead. Three-pointer. And no good.
Shocking that he just bricked that one. The defense got real lucky there.
Passes it to Gardner. Franklin for three. Rebounded by Roach. Pass to Grandison. Here's ABC. Shot clock at 6. No good with the triple. Virginia leading by 3. And here in the first, about 3 minutes in, launches a 3. That shot is no good, and he's 1 for 3 from the floor. Here's Roach. He provides a good amount of offense for the team, averaging around 11.5 points a game. Goes up at the stripe. The Cavaliers pull it in.
And you gotta love a team that can maintain its composure on the road. Take good shots and knock them down with confidence.
They took the air out of the crowd again and again with big shots. They never let the fans become a factor.
Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively, for sure.
goes up and lays it nice and easy.
And once he got to the 10, I think he was surprised to find himself that wide open.
Easy possessions like that literally are just a gift. You just dream of them. He'll gladly take those.
Clark outside. Pass to Gardner. Virginia working the ball around. Oh, and that one had the right spin on it, and it is good. Clark's got 5 points so far. So it's the visitors now. 6-point game.
I mean, they went into that one with the thought that they may have a chance. No.
You don't see a lot of blowouts in the NBA, so you're surprised whenever you see a lopsided score.
For Virginia, they've gone 50% from the field to this point, 4 of 8. Here's the screen. Now the pass to Gardner. And that one is hammered home.
My goodness, he is such a great dunker.
Greg, a high riser, no doubt about it. Gone 3 of 7 from the field since we've gotten underway.
And a moment here to look at some of the stats for Clark. He's getting around 8 points a game, 5 assists, and 3 rebounds. And he does so much for this team, but it starts with the way he leads the offense.
And he's willing to take on the scoring load. And look, he is more than capable of delivering.
And here is Mitchell. Here's Whitehead. A fadeaway J off the mark.
I don't know if he got in his own head there or what, because the defense can't really take credit for that miss.
Fires for three. Catchings with the rebound. Shooting in this first quarter, around 38%. They're looking a bit creaky out there. Here's Mitchell. No good that time. Cavaliers go the other way with it. He lobs up the alley-oop pass. Up high to stuff the alley-oop.
Oh, phenomenal alley-oop slam there.
They are taking advantage of a team that looks lost out there. Gotten just 3 of their first 9 shots to go down in this game. DJ passes to Young. Got 3 off the mark. Virginia leading by 8. Kicks to Clark. And the foul called on DJ. That's his first foul. And that kind of stifling effort on defense needs another look.
And guys, that is lockdown defense at its finest. Going right at the shot and then able to knock it away.
Oh. Shot clock at 5. Virginia needs to get off a shot. Clark for 3. No good on the shot. Whitehead deciding where to go with it. Pass to DJ. Now, here is Young. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game. Out of bounds, Virginia takes possession. With a break in the action, let's go to the 2K leaderboard for a look at this season's stingiest defensive teams.
I mean, terrific rim protection. I mean, they rotate and help on the inside as well as anybody. And, of course, you want to keep offenses on the outside shooting jump shots, and that continues to be the goal.
Here's Whitehead, coming in off a 10-point game his last outing. Pass to Young. Here's Catchings. Mitchell outside. Got a piece of it. 1:10 left in the first quarter of the game. And the shot is good.
And it just seems that every pass they make is leading to a score. Just great ball movement.
DJ with it. 9 points last game out. Here's Whitehead. Floats one up. Not gonna fall. Starting off slow, he misses his first 3 from the floor. 43 seconds left to play here in the first. Clark for 3. Whitehead with the rebound.
I'm shocked that didn't turn into 3 points. I mean, he makes you pay on those nearly every time.
Feeds it to Young. Trying to get something going. Count that one.
Yeah, another nice bucket down low. They've really been able to work the ball into the post effectively here so far.
First trip to the free throw line for him tonight.
And to this point on the season, guys, 80% from the line. He's done a really good job.
The kid, he's checked in for Whitehead. There's 25 seconds left in the first quarter. Hey, yo, right here. 15 seconds left to play in the first. 6 to shoot. Goes back up. Count that one. And the Cavaliers lead by 9.
Second chance points always hurt. Just not enough effort to block out.
Yeah, I'm going to go out on a limb here and say they need to emphasize rebounding going forward.
And so it's Virginia in control with a 9-point lead to end the quarter. Defensively, they have gotten after it, contesting every shot going up. Right back after this break. And so far through one quarter, it's been a lopsided game. We'll see if that changes here in the second. And a closer look here at the scoring breakdown for Virginia. Here's Grandison. Pass to Roach. It's rebounded by Virginia. ABC is out there with MP. Then it's the kid. Then it's Catchings. And it's Roach in at the point. Shoots from the right block. It's tipped. And there's the pass to Grandison. Here's Roach. Passes it to Catchings. And a miss there on the triple. The Cavaliers leading by 9. Quarter number 2. We're about a minute in. Shot from 12. Good for the basket. Starting off 1-for-1 with that shot.
They should continue to get the ball inside. The defense struggling to contain them.
Here's Roach. He had 15 points last out. And there's the drive. Gets it to fall from the right block. Roach has got his 3rd bucket of the night. And different games, different officials. Something that might be called a foul in one game, Greg, may not be called in the next. As a player, how do you adjust to that?
It's a great question, and that's part of being a veteran. I learned early on, you actually scout officials the same way you scout the players. They have tendencies as well.
Gone one of three to start out the second quarter. Some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, right now you just need a bucket to get some momentum.
Takes the 13-footer. ABC passes to Catchings. Five to shoot. And the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by MP. A moment here now to see the numbers for him. The Cavaliers leading by nine. To the middle. No good with the layup. Being just 31% in the game. Quarter two and just under 2.5 minutes gone by. Pass to Roach. Takes a three. Second shot opportunity. That one's not going to go. And it's the Cavaliers taking it the other way. Fires the three. Cavaliers with the rebound. Here's Franklin. It's hauled in by Grandison. Pass to Roach. Here's Grandison. And they'll get another chance. Here's MP. Another shot. And he sinks the layup.
That's a blue-collar bucket right there. Grown man basket. Put in the work. Got a second chance to score.
Here's Franklin. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here.
Yeah, way to play in attack mode and get to the line.
Virginia shooting their first shots from the stripe in this game.
And team free throw numbers really about as good as you could ask for. Around 80% on the season.
That's good from Franklin. So both teams changing it up here. And he can't hit the second. And just over 3.5 minutes played here in the second quarter. Here's Roach. He's covered by Clark. Grandison, no good. The Cavaliers leading by eight. Gardner passes to Clark. He kicks it to Franklin. Virginia working the ball around. The pass to Gardner. Here's Franklin. He's a good contributor to his team, averaging about 10.5 points a game. Off the inbound. The rebound by Mitchell. A terrible 27% from the floor. Boy, an off night for them, to say the least. Here's DJ. And it's off from three-point range. Cavaliers have gone 1-6 in the field in the second quarter. It's been a rough period so far. Passes to Gardner. Here's Franklin. Pass to Gardner. Shoots the three, drains it from beyond the arc. 7 points in the game.
And with the lead, I like the strategy here. Continue to get the ball to guys who can do something with it.
This is when good players really get after it. He can sense that they're reeling, and he's gonna put his foot on the pedal.
Here's DJ. After the Cavaliers pick up three, Franklin with the steal, and they're moving it up. Clark with a wide open look. They get it back. And the layup falls.
When you allow good scorers to get uncontested shots at the rim, no wonder you're losing.
That's a great possession. Put your best players in a position to succeed.
Now, here's DJ. Nothing yet on the scoreboard for him. Here's Whitehead. Clock at six. And that one hits back iron.
Ooh, might rush that one a little bit. Pretty clean look inside.
Pass to Clark. The pass to Franklin. Shot on the wing. Rebound by Mitchell. Here's Whitehead. And he can be counted on to put some points on the board every night. He's averaging right around 13.5 points a game. To stop the drought, he can't get that one to fall.
And the well is running dry for him right now. Nothing falling.
Yeah, and the risk now is that he gets inside his own head. Time to take deep breaths in through the nose, out through the mouth, and let the game come to you.
Here's Whitehead. Kicks it to DJ. He tries for three. That shot missing. And it's the Cavaliers taking it the other way. Clark dishes to Franklin. Back to Clark. And he could not get that one to go. A lot of contact, and he'll go to the line for two. For Virginia, they've shot two free throws, and they're 1-2 so far. And that one falls for Clark. And he makes both free throws.
And they're really getting more points at the free throw line here in the second quarter. They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
Young looking it over. Whitehead. Another miss, and they desperately need a bucket. The Cavaliers leading by 15. Passes it to Franklin. This one for three. The rebound by Young. Shot clock and game clock separated by less than 6 seconds. Mitchell outside. Now here's DJ. He's covered by Clark. Young sets a screen for DJ. Count it. Good. DJ's got his first bucket in this one.
And they've repeatedly probed inside in the first half, guys, and it's paid off.
And so it's Virginia with a sizable lead as the quarter wraps up. They're ahead 16 points. They've been playing some ferocious defense. And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Thanks very much. Coach, this team is still developing. What do they need to do to really reach their max?
Just keep working every day. Give maximum effort, great concentration, and play to win. Make winning plays.
Sounds simple, but I know it's not. Coach, thanks for your time. Back to you guys.
Okay, David, much appreciated. And now time for halftime. So we'll be back in just a bit to get the third quarter underway.
Welcome, everybody. This game revealing a big disparity in play. What a performance so far.
They've been disciplined offensively, taking care of the ball and working for good looks. And that's limited fast break opportunities for their opponent.
Disciplined, like Kenny at a steakhouse.
Indeed, baby. No steak right now.
And let's get back to our featured game, a fantastic battle between these two guys.
Well, you look at these two carrying the scoring load, both playing some fantastic basketball in the first half.
We'll see if the imminent halftime coaching adjustments can slow down either guy. Thanks for spending halftime with us. Time to get it back out to Kevin Harlan for the start of the third quarter.
And with the second half upon us, we'll find out if this game becomes the rout that it's threatening to be. Being a disastrous 25% from the field so far. To the left side wing. Pass to Grandison. Here's Roach. To the paint. Here's MP. And they call the foul, so a chance at the line for one more coming up.
It's a great move, and he catches the defense completely off guard.
Yeah, taking it right to the rim. One imagines that might be discussed at halftime. That's going to be on the film.
Hey, Richard, as soon as your playing career ended, you got right into this business, into broadcasting. When did you decide that this would be the next step?
Well, the first time is when I thought I was going to be out the league, and so I started doing more and more work until I retired in 2018. So it started way before I retired.
That laid the groundwork for you. Good job. Starting the second half, here's Ime Udoka's five. They've got MP. ABC is out there with the kid. Then there's Baddest One, and it's Roach in at the one spot. And that one falls for Clark. And he makes the first, but misses the second. Here's Whitehead. Still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him. Here's Grandison. From outside, off the mark.
Not quite enough defense that time around. Just lucky he was off.
Here's Franklin. There's the pass to Gardner. Here's Whitehead. His three-pointer's off the mark. The Cavaliers leading by 14. Gardner passes to Clark. They set the screen. Misses off the right iron. Gone 1-3 since starting the second half. First minute and a half of basketball here in the third quarter. Here's Grandison. And it's blocked. And that one ends up out of bounds. And they'll keep possession. You gotta love strong defense, especially when it comes in the form of harsh rejections. Wow.
And a block like that sends a message. One that says we're not giving up this lead.
Catchings is checked in for ABC. Virginia on D. Right hand shot is off.
Ooh, this is turning into a slow start here in the second half. Seems like they left that offense in the locker room.
Now Clark, 8 points for him. For three, Catchings with the rebound.
Well, despite some uneven shooting from him, they're still out in front.
Pass to Whitehead. Here's Grandison. Here's Roach. 6 points for him. That one a little long. There's a screen to the inside. 9 feet out. That one is good again. He's 6 for 8 from the floor with the basket.
And that's his M.O. Sometimes he can score more points by himself than the rest of the team.
Not quite 2.5 minutes played here in the second half. Guys, they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off.
And he gets the whistle. 2 free throws coming up.
Now we can take a look at MP. How his last 10 games have gone. Averaging about 4 points, 4 rebounds, and 2 assists. Nothing about his numbers really jump out at you, but he'll come up with a timely play or two every game.
And that's what you need from some guys on the team. Not everyone can be an all-star. You need glue guys to find that success, too.
That free throw missing.
Wow. What, did he have something in his eye on that shot?
Maybe. Young's checked in for Whitehead. Good on the second free throw. Well, Greg, we're seeing high schoolers now making 6 figures to play basketball. I bet you wouldn't have minded that in your time, would you?
I tell you what, it beats delivering the newspaper, right? It's still fresh and developing, but a lot of different opportunities are emerging.
Rough start to the second half for them, only getting 1 of the past 4 shots to fall.
Right now, let's send it over to the sidelines and get a report from David Aldridge.
Thanks, Kevin. We've heard about player tracking on the court, but now shot tracking is helping players refine their strokes. It measures not just makes or misses, but the arc and the depth and the left to right direction of shots. These systems provide instant feedback to shooters and help them find the bottom of the net. Kevin, back to you.
Sign me up. That is a fascinating story. David, thank you. Now, here's Clark. 8 points for him. And they recover it. Tries again. 4 on the clock. And it is flushed down with a nice jam.
There it is, guys. One of those effort plays that makes a big difference in the game.
And, GA, it is definitely making a difference so far today.
Offensive rebounding is about hustle and determination. Huge putback, making a statement there.
To the left wing. Passes it to Roach. Pass to Catchings. It's Young on the wing. 6 to shoot. Here's Roach. The basket good off the assist from Young. Roach has got 9 points.
You give a shooter of his caliber that much time to seam it up? Oh, yeah, you're done.
Inside and stolen by MP. Steps back. Here's Roach. That shot is off. And Virginia going the other way now. And the pass to Clark. The three drills the three-pointer. Clark's got 4 points in the quarter.
His first triple of the second half. Can he get it going?
And they just can't seem to get going offensively.
And coach called his timeout to try and reset things on offense. Shake them up a bit so they can hopefully start getting some shots to fall.
Here we are in November, and let's see how things are going out east in the early season. You take a look at Virginia. They reside in the seventh slot right now in the early part of the season. Quite a few spots down the ladder right now.
And I think for the Cavaliers, they had the kind of hot and cold start that we've kind of come to expect. Nothing that would indicate they're in for any kind of a breakout season.
They do look like they're the same kind of team they were last year. Good, but not special.
Virginia on D. Pass to Grandison. He doesn't hit that one. And Virginia going the other way now.
And that's the battle they haven't been winning today. Their work on the glass has been porous, and that's got to change.
Down low. Catchings with the rebound. Catchings has got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. He kicks it to DJ. Mitchell, a screen on Clark. A three-pointer, no good. The Cavaliers leading by 15. From 17 feet out, the rebound by Young.
Really thought he had this one, and the defense, they were giving it to him.
The feed to Mitchell. Count the bucket, coming off a perfectly placed assist. Mitchell's got his first 2 points.
And that tells the tale here today, guys. Throughout this game, they've been able to get the ball in tight and finish.
There's a minute 40 left to play in the third.
Now, taking a look at some stats for Mitchell. How last month turned out for him, he's been putting up about 4 points a game, 3 rebounds, and 2 assists. Not bad numbers, but for a player of his talent, you have to think he can do more.
Yeah, there's no doubt he has been inconsistent, which is unusual for him. But when he turns it back around, boy, you better watch out.
The first free throw is good. ABC's checked in for Catchings. And that one goes in, 2 from the line that time.
For a star like him, you get lots of opportunities at the line, and he's great at cashing them in.
Grandison passes to DJ. High post, Young. Can't hit from in close. The Cavaliers leading by 15. 1:12 left in the third quarter. To the middle. Power down after the assist led him into the lane.
And one step ahead of the defense with that solid screen.
And then, Greg, the monster dunk to finish it off.
Oh, great chemistry on display. He understood where to put the screen in order to free up his teammate.
Grandison, no good.
His consistency just hasn't been there this quarter in terms of his shooting.
That one drops for him. He's got 8.
He has been a key factor for them offensively, scoring with consistency.
There's 48 seconds left in the third quarter. They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill.
And it's DJ missing. And for Virginia, they're shooting a troubling 38% in the third. Not the finest work of this offense. Passes it to Franklin. Clock at 4. Off target from 3-point range.
And this will be the last possession of the quarter if they're patient.
Yeah, it's all about clock management with these situations. Let's see how that plays out.
And that one misses. No luck that time either. From deep three-point range, and the last shot at the buzzer doesn't go in for him. And so it's Virginia taking a 19-point lead into the break. Barring a disaster, it would appear they've got this game in the bag. We come back right after this. And it's time now to bring you our State Farm Assist of the Game.
And the definition of teamwork right there, guys. I mean, what great communication between them, and what a beautiful feed.
Serving it up on a platter, that is a beautiful dish. And two teammates on the same page, woo!
And one quarter to go in a game that, to this point, has not been an evenly fought contest. The Cavaliers leading by 19. That's tipped. ABC is out there with Mitchell. Then it's MP. Then there's Baddest One. And it's Roach in at the point guard.
And how about the communication between teammates on that alley-oop?
And that's what you need to pull that thing off. And for Virginia, their shooting has been wayward so far. Only 37% from the floor. And the foul called on MP. That's his first foul. Clark, he's checked in for Virginia. Here's Gardner. No good from outside.
And I thought that was going to drop. It looked good from here.
1 minute now into this fourth quarter. Pass to Roach. Shot clock at 6. The pass to Whitehead. Lets the 3 fly. Bangs home the trifecta. Whitehead's got himself going with the triple, his first basket of the game. Virginia leading by 14. To the paint. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul. And let's take a moment, guys, to get your take on the scoring so far for the Cavaliers. That one is off. No good on the second free throw. Final quarter of play, about a minute and a half off the clock into it. Catchings passes to Roach. Pass to Whitehead. Just 5 to shoot. Mitchell uses the glass to finish the layup.
I like the intention, the focus, finding a way to make it work inside.
And Clark has got the ball here for the Cavaliers. Nothing doing offensively yet for them in the fourth. We're about 2 minutes into the fourth quarter in this one. Again, the miss by Virginia.
And they're up right now, but it hasn't been because of him. He's really struggled on offense.
Passes to Catchings. Puts it up from 12. And a rebound goes to the Cavaliers. Earlier in the game, they had a 19-point lead. Just a little under 2.5 minutes have passed now here in the fourth. Gordon, covered by Mitchell. 6 on the shot clock. Clark for 3. No good on that one. Gone 3 of 4 in field goal attempts since getting things started here in the fourth. Back to Mitchell. Here's Roach. MP with a screen on Clark. Roach, no good. Virginia leading by 12. Kicks it to Clark. Pass to Gardner. Can they get it? And it's MP with the rebound. MP's got rebound number 9 now. What an effort here tonight. The pass to Roach. MP with a screen on Clark. Roach passes to MP. Here's Whitehead. For 3, Mitchell. The shot, no good. Pass to Gardner. Stolen by Mitchell. Out left to the wing. Here's Whitehead. Good, and it's Mitchell picking up the assist.
And you can tell he's starting to figure things out here in the second half.
Timeout called, Virginia. Young's checked in for Mitchell. And while we've got a moment, let's send it over to our terrific reporter, David Aldridge. David?
Hey, Kevin. Well, during the break, I heard Tom Thibodeau as he talked with the team. He's encouraged where they are at this point in the game, but he told his guys, things can turn in a blink. What we need to do is execute the rest of the way. So we'll see if they can finish this one off, Kevin.
Thanks so much, David. Virginia leading by 9. And it's Clark in the corner. The Cavaliers again can't hit. Gone 4 of 7 from the field since the beginning of the fourth. Catchings passes to Whitehead. MP with a screen on Clark. Here's Roach. Here's MP. Bucket is good.
Well, they left it until the fourth quarter, but finally the run they needed to get back into this one.
I'm sure they wish they made this run sooner, but they've still got time to come away and steal this one.
That was a second look at our Mobile One drive. Amazing control on display.
And putting that pressure on the rim. That's what it's all about, threatening with that attack.
And he gets the bucket.
And you can sense them just starting to squeeze and shrink this lead a little bit.
Here's Roach.
And they just can't seem to get going offensively.
And coach called his timeout to try and reset things on offense. Shake them up a bit so they can hopefully start getting some shots to fall.
The Kiddies check in for Catchings. Anderson passes to Whitehead. Young outside. Pass to Roach. Shot clock at 6. Over Clark. Roach, no good.
Let's just say his subpar shooting is just one reason why they are trailing in this ballgame.
Clark left side. Sweet little floater. And it's an 11-point Cavalier lead.
Making the floater look this smooth is not as easy as it looked. It's a challenging shot.
Gone 5 for 9 from the field in the final quarter so far. Here's Roach. Floats it up for Young. Hammers the alley-oop through.
And all of a sudden, that great run makes this a ball game again. And now is no time to take your foot off the gas. They have got to stay aggressive.
It's one thing to get close, but do they have enough left in the tank to take the lead? We'll have to see.
Good on the three-point shot.
And the lack of effort to fight over the screen there makes that an easy shot.
Yeah, as soon as these guys feel contact, they are just disappearing like they're not even there. You gotta show some fire and keep defending.
Here's Roach. After Virginia picked up 3 with their last shot. Pass to Gardner. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Baddest one. That is his first foul of the game. ABC's checked in for Young. .153 left in the fourth quarter. ABC grabs the board. ABC has got 6 rebounds in the game. There's Whitehead. Oh, and there's the one-handed jam.
And guys, he's not an easy man to stop when he's got the rim in his sights.
Never has been, never will be. He is a determined finisher. And there's the pass to Gardner. 1:25 left in the fourth quarter. 6 to shoot. Clark outside. That 3 off target. Had some space there after the little pump fake. Here's Roach. He's covered by Clark. And Roach gets it to go.
Look at the space he had on that one, though. There's an obvious speed mismatch between the two.
Virginia leading by 8. Clark outside. Gardner passes to Clark. Just 4 to shoot. No good on the wing 3. 40 seconds left in the fourth. Here's Grandison. Banked in off the glass.
And that's right where they wanted to go with the ball, in rhythm.
We've got 33 seconds left here in the fourth quarter. And an intentional foul right there. Good on the first, and that makes it a 7-point lead. And so he drops them both. It's an 8-point game. What's your take, guys?
Well, they'll need a very quick basket out of this timeout.
Whitehead passes to Grandison. 8 second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Here's Roach. And the shot is long. So it's the Cavaliers now. Feeds it to Clark. Well-timed pass, and he goes straight to the bucket for the layup. And the Cavaliers lead by 10.
And you can sense that these fans, these players, they are ready to celebrate.
It's always nice to perform like this, especially in front of the faithful home crowd.
So we see the Cavaliers get the win here. Even early on in this one, it seemed like they were happy to be playing at home tonight.
And it makes a big difference. Once they started to really play in rhythm, you never felt like they had any doubts as to whether or not they were going to win.
And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. This is Kevin Harlan thanking you for watching. And now, it's time to present the New Balance Player of the Game.